Live Response gives a SecOps analyst instantaneous access to a potentially compromised machine, regardless of location, by using a remote shell. Analysts use this capability to quickly gather any forensic information that an investigation requires. I'll demonstrate how to enable and use Live Response in Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. To enable Live Response, select Settings, followed by Endpoint, and then Advanced Features. Only admins and users who have managed portal settings permissions can enable Live Response. You'll see three options. First, turn on Live Response to enable the core Live Response functionality. You can enable Live Response for both clients and servers, but I'll just focus on clients here. By default, analysts can only run signed scripts for obvious safety reasons. However, you can also turn on Live Response unsigned script execution to give them the ability to run unsigned PowerShell scripts. This is not required to use the built-in Live Response functionality, though. Last, select Save Preferences. Now that Live Response is enabled, let's look at how to use it. That's next. You can start a Live Response session almost anywhere you see a device's details, like the flyouts you see when you select a device in a list. In this case, I'll start the session from a device's details page. To get started, select the Meatball menu at the top of the page, and then select Initiate Live Response Session. And here we go. First, I'll review information in the Live Response console. Select View Device Details to show what Microsoft Defender for Endpoint knows about it. You can also see who created the session, when it started, and how long it's been open. There are specific commands that we can use in Live Response. If you're not sure what they are, just type Help. And in Microsoft Docs, the page titled Investigate Entities on Devices Using Live Response offers a full list of basic and advanced commands available in Live Response. I'll go ahead and look at the running processes by running the processes command, and it displays a list of all the running processes. Quickly scrolling through them, I don't see anything that sticks out as suspicious. I also want to search for a malware file that Microsoft Defender for Endpoint previously blocked, just to make sure it doesn't need to be removed from a download location. Doesn't look like this is still around, which is a good thing. Last, I want to run a quick PowerShell script to back up the event log so I can download it. To do that, I'm going to select Upload File to Library and select my script. The option to upload a file to the library is only available to users with Manage Security Settings permission. After the script uploads, I can verify it's in the library by running the library command. To run any script in the library, just type run, followed by the name of the script. Once it finishes, we'll copy the log path and run the file info command to get more information about it. Last, I want to download this file to my device to review it. To do that, I'll run the get file command. And that's it. By the way, if you ever want to go back to reference what you've done during the session, select command log. I can then select the processes command I ran earlier to review its full output. Finally, when you're done, just select Disconnect Session to, well, end the session. Microsoft Defender for Endpoint logs all your activities in the Action Center for audit purposes. Audit logging provides useful documentation for other analysts and helps to discourage nefarious use of Live Response. Live Response provides security analysts with real-time access to users' devices, even when they're not on the corporate network. Learn more about it on Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.